We have breaking news tonight. Sir Michael Parkinson has died at the age of 88. The famous British broadcaster, well known for his gentle but probing interview style, sitting down with everyone from Muhammad Ali to John Lennon.
That theme drew millions to the television sets each week.
Evening and welcome.
If you wanted the sure sign that you'd made it as a celebrity, sitting next to Michael Parkinson would do it. Born in Yorkshire in 1935, the son of a miner, he started his journalism career straight out of school in newspapers. And in 1971, started the program that made him a household name.
I think you've got to accept, John and Yoko, that, particularly you, John, that it's alienated you from the people who originally loved you in this country.
A lot of them, yeah.
Yes, I think they don't understand you anymore. Listen,
the alienation started was when I met Yoko, and people do not seem to like people getting a divorce.
I think he had to clear the decks in order to give Yoko space. So this was now his new relationship, and being a good, loving guy, he had to kind of get rid of the old mates. But the great thing about it was that after all that warring, before he died, we did make it up.
As a journalist, he'd done his homework on each guest. As an interviewer, he knew how to bring out their best.
I think the most important thing about interviewing is to actually establish a relationship with the person sitting opposite, because after all, it's a totally phony operation, all this nonsense around, you know, palaver, walk down the stairs, a band playing, all that sort of stuff. And I don't care who you are, when you're reasonable on the stairs, you see this stranger opposite you, me, you think, well, what the hell am I doing here?
Are there any tricks of the trade, Mom, about you know, meeting people, walk about, talking to people?
Yes, I think there probably are.
How bad was a drugs and alcohol situation?
Well, I did ring up the office one day to complain that the wind was too windy.
You'd be voted the sexiest man of the century, for God's sake.
Well, they have great taste.
Of all his thousands of guests, his most famous sparring partner was the greatest, Muhammad Ali.
I love your show and I like your style, but your pay is so cheap, I won't be back for a while.
Four interviews over a decade.
He had that physical presence, which could threaten you. I mean, joke
about
it.
Were you ever frightened of him?
None again.
Parkinson himself was nearly always genial and unflappable, although he wasn't afraid to tackle Kerry Packer over World Series cricket.
He actively recruited people, Kerry, while he was captain of England, privy to important information on the other side.
There hasn't been any important information on the other side for 100 years.
He was in the...
He was a frequent visitor to Australia.
We met in the lift in Sydney, I think, for the first time, many years ago, my second home, Sydney.
In 1979, he brought his program down under, inviting our biggest names into his Sydney studio.
He's been described as Australian as Vegemite. Ladies and gentlemen, Bob Hawke. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Farnham. Ladies and gentlemen, Bert Newton. It's very interesting going to Australia. You know, it's such a long, long way away that when you get there, it's like being on another planet. And everything that worries you in Europe and everything that bothers you in Britain disappears.
It left him with a soft spot for Aussie larrikins.
Hello, darling.
Hello, dear.
Here we are again.
Embracing Dame Edna.
Funnily enough, exciting though it has been, I felt a sense of gratitude from the audience when I came on.
Calling Shane Warne a genius.
Tell us a story about the boomerang. I love this story.
I've still got the scar just here.
This is a metaphor for your life, you know, this is.
Sort of threw the boomerang and didn't quite get it right. And then once I got it right and sort of just kept going around, I thought, oh, that's pretty good. And suddenly it started coming towards me. I thought, geez, I better try and catch that.
Parkinson later admitted the toll being in the spotlight took on him.
After the death of my father, which affected me greatly, I just hit the bottle. I didn't become an alcoholic. I pulled back. I went and sought advice, and Mary was wonderful.
For his final show, he brought in his all-time favourite guests, including the Scottish comedian he'd helped make a star.
Don't go! Please don't go, it's the only television I get.
In his later years, he had a long fight with cancer, but there were no complaints, just reflections on a life spent seeking answers.
I loved every minute of it. I've been a very, very lucky man indeed.
In London, Brett McLeod, Nine News.